What's up? You ready? What's up? You like the stash? Ooh. All right. So, when getting into the stancy pants, little tilty boy options with suspension, you have a nice two options. You either have air suspension, where you're just kind of like, oh, enjoying the day, you know, riding along, press a little button, the little doom, you know, right there, and then it's like, or you can man the fuck up, put yourself on some coilovers, slam the ground, and be baller as hell and stun on some homies. Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Jasper from Fitment Industries, and today I'm gonna be talking about why you should be going static. I hope you're having a great day. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and let's get right into it. First things first, when you buy coilovers, you have a large variety of adjustability, going from lifted to completely slamming your car on its nuts. So with coilovers, depending on what you want, you're gonna get a smooth or a stiff ride between spring rates and dampening. You can adjust the little deets on top and get your nice, perfect ride height so you can drive either, well, honestly, that's your case. You can either go in a 40K and completely just feel like you're just on welded struts, or you can really feel like you're about to just ship the Titanic out there with your nice 2K spring rates, just really, you know, doing your thing. So when it comes to handling, air suspension has proven time and time again that it does do well on the track and it can handle correctly. But you always have the chance of one of many of your components breaking. Which leads to my next point. With coilovers, when something goes wrong, you have about three or four things that could go wrong. Either your threads are gonna strip or seize, your springs are gonna break, or your struts can blow out. And when it comes to air suspension, if something breaks, more than likely it's gonna be very expensive, it's gonna be hard to find, and it's also just kind of a pain in the ass. When it does come down to it, the sheer point of why people do go static is really the same point of why you buy cool wheels. It just looks good. And one of the biggest issues I have with air suspension is that the second you want to drive anywhere, your car looks like a 4x4 Jeep, aka Jared's car. Dialing in a static car for perfect fitment is something that takes time, patience, and endless hours into just making sure the wheels sit perfectly with your car. From experience, I do know the situations of nothing going right and everything just going terrible just to get your wheel as close as you can to your fender just to mess it up in the future. But we are willing to make these sacrifices of banging your frame, busting your oil pan, and ruining your subframe just to make your car static. And it'll always look good. And that's the whole main point of going static, is that you're willing to take these sacrifices into going through the shitty parts of driving a static car because of how it looks all the time. Now, with that being said, we do sell coils, wheels, tires, and suspension at fitmentindustries.com. I'm Jasper from Fitment Industries, and I'll talk to you guys later. Peace.